Ooh, should probably fix this. While I fix it, there we go. Hey guys, welcome to Mitch playing some Dark Cloud. So yeah, still not Sora. Sorry about that. He's still having laptop issues at the moment. But that's why I'm here, to take over while he fixes his stuff. But anyway, so this is Dark Cloud. We will be playing that on the PS2 for the next, say, 3 hours. Definitely one of my favorite games. Alright, now that the introductions are done, hey guys, this is going to be me playing Dark Cloud for the next few hours. So Sora still unavailable, he's got laptop issues, so I'm going to be taking over and my name is Mitch. So still having webcam issues myself. I really have to get that fixed, and I will. Oh, we don't want to see this again. Damn it. Alright, hang on. But, basically, I'll be playing through this game. Oh boy, it was so fun as a kid. It gave me a lot of trouble because I was stupid as a kid. I couldn't get past the first boss. But, having played this game for many hours, learning all the tricks and stuff, I think I can confidently say we're gonna have fun. Oh, this game doesn't have any voices at all, so I'll be trying to do the voices with my horrible voice, which you are all so well acquainted with. A book was found in some old ruins. All the scholars who decoded it puzzled over the mystery of the book. A world with two moons illuminating the sky. The many dazzling adventures of a young boy. But whether or not this is a true story, do you believe in the story woven in the book? Maybe it's a fantasy that existed only in a boy's heart. Let me tell you this story. This ancient book tells of a magical and magnificent fairy tale, and the hero of this wondrous tale, whose name is... Oh yeah, we get to decide what the name is. It's gonna be Mitch. Spoilers, but still. His real name is Tone. And my bird fell. I don't know why. Oh, he got back up. Alright. Let's go full name. Full first name. Yes. The Dark Shrine. Pretty cool dance so far. Oh, you've gathered quite a few.
I had a hard time finding dancers with the right qualifications. Look at them, they're dance of blood. Mixing the blood of witches and that of humans is key to the performance. However, I do have some problem.
Problem?
In order to proceed,
I can't do this. I'll just let you read it, spare you the stupidity of my voices. There's gonna be quite a few more minutes of this. It's over now. There we go. Here comes Jafar! No, I'm kidding, it's not Jafar. Damn. Wait, where'd all the dancers go? Meanwhile, in the land of the protagonist. Oh, I can finally skip these. Okay. I can't do female voices very well, so I'll skip the female voices. Damn, wish I could eat that fast in real life. I can't. Like something bad's gonna happen now. It's too happy. Oh, there we go. Alright. Time for the most graceful end of the world dance ever. Don't worry, nothing can kill the protagonist. The protagonist always lives. Oh. Yeah, he's dead now. Well, short game. Oh, never mind. Let me think of a good old man voice for this. I am the Fairy King. I'm the entity that unites all of nature's spirits. Listen well, young one. Something bad has happened. Yeah, no shit. Men blinded by greed have revived the dark genie. This dark genie is terribly powerful.
Its power is so great that it could destroy the entire world. You saw it. Your own village being destroyed right in front of your eyes. Not just your village. In a flash, many villages and towns were destroyed. In one night, half of your world was annihilated.
Wait, what about the girl? He only saved me and not the girl? Well,
it must be the men from the east that performed the resurrection ceremony. Probably thinking to use its black demon power for war without realizing how frightening it is. It is darkness, pure darkness itself. Long ago, this so-called dark genie almost destroyed the entire world. Its malevolence is that great. The bad thing is that it has the same type of magical power as a spirit. Unfortunately, we aren't powerful enough to destroy it. Young man, I see that you have a strong will that could withstand the evil power. And also a clear, kind heart. You might be able to fight against the darkness it generates. I decided to stake our fate on you. Let me bless you with power. There, surprise. That's called Atlamelia. It's a stone with a magical power. Oh, don't look that way, boy. I'll explain now. It might get too bright for your eyes for a minute.
Okay, I can't do the voice anymore. My throat hurts. It seems those Atlo were scattered all around by its tremendous magic power. They were probably blown to different places around the world. It probably thinks everything is destroyed. You must restore the world before it realizes what happened. Well, the place is pretty clean, no rubble or anything. So, either the genie cleaned everything up, or this happened. Absorb that which I sealed in Atla using the Atla mirror, and bring them back. Then you'll be able to restore the world to its original form. You may even be able to create an even better world than before. You don't seem to understand anything I'm saying. Oh, well, I'll give you another lesson when you acquire some apple. So long. Well, nice to know the dark genie spared all the butterflies. And voices of the earth, they are all calling for your help. You will probably meet and say goodbye to many people. In talking to these people, you may receive clues to defeat the darkness. Look for them. Now, Mitchell, your adventure begins. First, go to the village chief's house. He'll show you where to go next.
No ruined village!
Alright. Ooh, is it inverted? I'll deal with it. So, this is the chief's house. Alright, I can't deal with it. Worst options. Look inversion. version. Wow, they do not have look. Okay. Let's make message display speed normal so I can read it. Clock display on, time progress on, vibration. Oh yeah, vibration on. Alright, they don't have look inversion, I'll deal with it.
Oh, Mitchell, you are alive! Seems like we're the only ones in the village that survived. We never dreamt this would happen. One night and our village is gone. Can you believe this, Mitchell? I feel so helpless. I, the mayor of the village, can't do anything about it. What am I supposed to do now? I guess the only thing we can do is to get help from the guardian of Noroon Village, Drain. Drain will not abandon us. He'll help us for sure. I have a favor to ask, Mitchell. Go to the Divine Beast Cave and tell Dran what happened.
Listen, blinking red text means you have to either say it in a really deep voice or not do anything at all. So I just won't do anything at all.
Divine Beast Cave is the cave outside towards your right-hand side. You've probably seen it before. I may be imagining things, but I sense something has changed about the cave. Be careful. This is the cave key.
Yoink.
I put the things you might need in your bag for you. Now, don't get carried away. If you get in trouble in there, come back here, I'll get you more supplies. Good luck!
Alright, where the... anything in here? A spiky bug's coming out! Alright. Oh boy, there's a lot of game mechanics in this game, but I will explain it all when I get in the cave. And you wanna know where that cave is? All the way here. How do I... there we go. And it's locked, so we need to use a key. Let's use the cave key. I'd like to apologize in advance for my crappy voice. Ooh, excellent. Let's go to the first floor. Oh, great. You again. Yeah, I'm not gonna do the voice. My throat hurts. I'll just read it normally. It's for real this time. From here on, you will be put to the true test. First, conquer this wretched Divine Beast's cave and find Dran's lair. That's your first goal. Since you're a beginner, I'll give you a lesson on how to fight in the dungeon. First, to advance to the next floor in a dungeon, acquire a gate for the next door leading to the next floor. Each dungeon has a different gate key. For the Divine Beast Cave, Drain's Crest will be the gate key. The gate key is almost always carried by a monster in the dungeon. You must defeat the monsters to acquire the gate key. Since you can't tell which one has the key, you just have to defeat them all one by one. Next, I'll tell you about how to return to the ground level, rather than advancing to the floor below. To return to the ground level, mind connect with me. In other words, speak with your mind. When you do this, I will transport your body to the ground level. Just select Leave Dungeon from the main menu. But be aware, if there are monsters left on the floor, the mind connect won't work. It will be blocked by their evil energies. In such cases, use the item Escape Powder to get out on your own. The Norun Village Chief has lots of it, so be sure to get it before you go. You can also mind connect with me when you go through the gate to the next floor of a dungeon. When you re-enter the dungeon, you can start on the next new level so you don't have to worry about losing your progress. Next, it's on to weapons. Be aware that means that weapons are breakable. Oh great, this bullshit again. When has breakable weapons ever been a good idea in video games? The more you use a weapon, the more it wears. And finally, it breaks. Broken weapons will disappear. To prevent weapons from breaking, use the item Repair Powder. It will restore their WHP, which is weapon hit points. The longer you use a weapon by repairing, the more magic it absorbs from monsters and thus becomes stronger. It's said that when a weapon reaches its full strength, it can change to a more powerful form. Keep that in mind. Oh, I cast a special spell on the dagger you have on you, so it'll never disappear. But all the new weapons you will get during the quest will disappear once they break, so be careful. Don't waste your hard work by letting a weapon break and disappear. Finally, the important stuff. The Sphere Atla, which I protected and sealed the fragments of the world. If you see an Atla, don't hesitate to touch it. You can absorb the contents of an Atla into Atlamelia by touching it. When you return to the surface, you will be able to begin reassembling these fragments of the world. Oops, today's lesson ran a little long. That's it for today's lecture. Now, show me your true ability on this quest. Phew, now it's my turn to explain the game mechanics. Oh good, I already hear feedback. So your map is located at the bottom right. Let's see. Triangle is the menu display. So you can only hold some amount of items. Currently, I can only hold 50. You get things to boost the amount of items you can hold. Let's see. You also have a weapon slot here, which stores all your weapons for all the characters, and your attachments. I'll get into attachments later. First, how do I... No, that's not it. Square, circle. Circle, box on. X is slash. And goodbye, you little bastards. And I got bread! I am bread. No. Alright, chests are scattered throughout the entire dungeon. This is one of the three items of a dungeon. There's a magical crystal, which lets you know where all of the things are. Yellow dots are chests, green dots are the apple orbs, red dots are enemies. There we go, got Macho. And you see those three little boxes above? Those are your special item slots. Basically, what you put in there are items that you can use at any time. Like, say, like, the most important thing you'll find in the game is probably the Dran Feather. The Dran Feather is the most important item in the game. If you ever find it, use it. It lasts so long, and it cuts the game's time by like half. Alright, so you saw what the magical egg does. Magical egg tells you the position of all the items, and monsters, and Atla. Ooh, I'll explain what this question mark is later. The other item you can get is the map. The map just gives you the full visible map. It doesn't show you where all the stuff is, but it just shows you a map. And then lastly, that question mark. Every dungeon has a secret item that you can get from the chests, in most cases. And that secret item allows you to go to the back floor of a dungeon. The back floor is like the same as a normal floor, only it's darker, and all the enemies are much more stronger. However, there is a good side to it. The back floor has really good items. And I mean really good. Yeah, you better run. Well, so cave bats are very annoying. Oh, that's why. Yeah, get wrecked, cave bat. Good thing I have one antidote. There is... Oh, this is where you put the gate key, if I find it. And there's one more thing I have to talk about. This thing, in every dungeon, there is a waterfall type thing. Once you get in it, you're at full health. Automatically. And you can go back and do it however much you want. You can just keep doing it over and over. Yeah, get over here. Oh crap. Oh, damn. It's alright. These little coin pouches are just money pouches. Money is really important in this game. Yeah, what you gonna do? And the abs on my weapon is full. Let's see. Attribute customized. We don't have any items that we can put here, which sucks. Let's just open the chest first. Maybe we can get an item. You can customize your item with different gems, different little stone things, and different magic crystals. Oh, premium water. Alright, I guess I can't really upgrade. Guess there's no point in upgrading. I will just level this up with no item. It didn't restore the hit points. Oh well. Get wrecked. Ah, oh, great, these little shitbats. Really? No key? Alright. So unfortunately, the beginning of the game is probably the most difficult part. You can only get one of each item. Repair powders are just so important, and you only get one per floor, when you usually need like two or three. And your speed in moving the dungeon is really slow. At least until you get a Dran Feather. Those are very important. I cannot emphasize how important they are. Okay, bread. Come on. And stamina drink. Stamina drinks? Oh, this is awesome. Check this out. Big chests are super rare. Oh, and this is a locked chest. So basically, you can guess what the trap is. Always... Oh, alright, I wanted to guess explosion. It was curse. Curse isn't that bad. But I guessed it correctly, and I get a free weapon. Base Lord. Thank you, Base God. Base Lord. Base something. I don't know. But hey, let's equip our base lord here. Alright, there's two monsters left. One of you has to have the gate. Ah, crap. Yeah, there's the gate key. Alright, now let's get this Atla. And we got Rogue. So one more thing I should probably explain. The bottom left bar is the weapon speed. Basically what that is that's your attacking speed. Once that bar goes down all the way, your combo ends. And you can't really continue from there. You just have to wait till your weapon bar refills all the way, and that's how you can continue attacking. Now, depending on which character you use, the weapon bar has different uses. Not really uses, but it works in different ways. Also, if you hold down the X button, you can charge your weapon attack, and you do this funny shifting move here. And this wastes a lot of your weapon hit points, as you can see on the top. I'm getting thirsty. It's alright, we have water. And let's use the gate key here. Alright, let's leave the dungeon, talk to the chief, get a repair powder, and come back. Oh boy. Don't worry, I won't do the voices anymore. Not unless if they're gonna be good voices. Ha ha ha, seems like you've finally come back with some apple. Very well then, I shall teach you as I promised. Okay, I can explain this pretty well for you guys, so let's just ignore this. Yes, 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 we know. Oh, thank you for this very super important manual. Now, a quick way to move is just go into your editing mode and just come here. Easy. Now let's go to Beatles HQ, because you know, it's a yellow submarine. Where did they get this idea? A yellow submarine? Hey, can I get more items? Did I get more? Yeah, he gave me more. You only get one of each. So that's why the beginning of the game is just super annoying. But honestly, this game is one of my favorites. It sucks that they never remade this for PS3. So, to the three people who are watching this right now, how's your day going? Mine's going pretty well. Got a random idea to play this all of a sudden. I was playing Final Fantasy. Oh, what's going on? Alright. It's a cat. Cat's gone. Interesting. Alright, so as I was saying, I was playing Final Fantasy X HD Collection before, but I wanted to play this, because, you know, first rule of streaming, stream what you like. No, wait, that's the second rule. First rule is don't be an asshole. Second rule, stream what you like. Third rule, talk with the chat. Fourth rule, what was the fourth rule? I don't remember what the fourth rule is, but there was a fourth rule. And fifth rule, if all else fails, don't talk about Fight Club. That's the fifth rule of streaming. Yeah, come here, you little skeletal bastard. Your main goal in all of the floors, regardless, collect all of the Atla orbs. Regardless, always collect them all. You never want to finish a floor and have that one Atla orb that you never collected, then you have to go back, and it's super annoying. What do you want? You want to die, that's what you want. Oh, yes. Interesting. Sometimes when you kill an enemy, what is that? Oh, shit. Yeah, get wrecked. And let's open this. Hey, there's the little Easter egg. Now we know the position of every item on this floor. Oh, interesting. So this, that endurance one that you saw me just get, that is one of the weapon attachments. So let me show you here. Basically, customizing a weapon. A weapon has a lot of stats to it. It's got weapon hit points. If your weapon hit points reach zero, the weapon breaks. Unless it's your beginning weapon. Your abs is basically your absorption. When it absorbs enough magical power, you can upgrade it. And when you upgrade it, all of these that you put here get upgraded with it. Your speed is basically how fast you attack with it. MP is the magical power of the weapon. You really don't need this for most of the characters. These are your attributes: fire damage, ice damage, thunder, wind, and holy. And then these. These are your enemy attributes, which is like higher damage to dragons, to beasts, sky people, metal people, mimics, mage. There's a lot of these. Also, I would like to apologize in advance in case you hear my birds singing in the background. Oh, well, three birds. I have two pet birds, I'm pet sitting another bird. So it's three birds total, all canaries. And they are making a lot of noise. So I would like to apologize in advance. Oh, come on. At least you didn't poison me. Alright. And now, prepare. Oh, basically, you can upgrade your weapon. This tells you what you need required to upgrade it. But unfortunately, Base Lord is not the weapon I am looking for. I know, right? I'm sorry, Base God, but Base Lord is not the weapon I'm looking for. Oh, hang on. Let's eat some bread first, because my health is pretty low. Now let's attack this walking shit pile here. Alright. I hear bats. I hate bats. Yeah, but that bat got wrecked. These Atla Orbs, they're only for the, oh, what was that? Alright. The Atla Orbs are only for the Georama. And I'll explain what that is once this floor is over. Oh! Power-up powder is an excellent item here. It automatically levels up your weapon. Of any choice. Just choose one, use it, and it levels up instantly. Which is pretty cool. Especially for late game. When your weapons require so many abs in order to level up. Right, let's keep going. That's the end of the floor, we don't have the gate key. And I need to go to the top over there and get the Georama. Or the Atla. Sorry, Georama is where you put all the Atla. I hear something. Yeah. Come here, fat ass. Oh my god! Alright. I got this. Base Lord. Whoops. Alright, you definitely hear my bird now. Holy crap. Really, would like to apologize about the birds in the background. And the lack of webcam. I'm sorry, I am just having so much issue with the webcam at the moment. But hey, you guys should be happy, you don't have to see my ugly face. So before, you saw me get the skeleton key from the chest. Basically, every dungeon has its own separate mini-gate. Oh my god. Will that bird please be quiet? So every floor has a secret, not really a secret, it has a mini gate, and you need to open one of the chests to get the little gate key. Not the gate key the enemies drop, but the gate key that the chest has. So here, we'll use the bone key. Two more enemies. Yamich! Ah, fuck. Gonna need more bread. Come on, turn around. Hit skeletal fucktard over here. And there's the gate key. One thing I've noticed about this game, the gate key, 90% of the time, it will be the last enemy you kill. Oh, I forgot to upgrade base lore. Customize. And let's upgrade. Alright. So now that we got the gate key, we can go on. Although I really can't go on because I need to get some repair powder. Oh boy. Alright. The gate to the next floor is all the way down here. And let's go. Let's leave the dungeon. I guess now I can work on some of the Giorama. So basically, you can go into editing mode this way, and triangle to configure and assemble. You've got all these things. You got roads, you got trees, you got rivers. These are rivers, not roads, my bad. And these are little things that you can add. Basically, each Giorama is like a puzzle piece. So let's see, Macho's house. Well, here's Macho. And here's Ka-Macho. Short, big brother. So, let's put them down. Let's put them down right here. And let's go talk to them. Oh, these are nice little things. Basically, if I could open this, here we go. Basically, throughout the game, once you put down houses and complete their tasks, you get those little brown chests to appear. Alright, did I just go outside? Yeah, I just went outside. I'm an idiot.
Okay, those little brown chests, they have excellent items in them, like half the time.
Say, what happened to the day at the festival? Remember, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Now, this is what you always have to ask them. You always have to ask them, how should I rebuild? Wait, tell me how to rebuild your house. And he tells you the extra parts that you need for your house. Well, not his house, anyway. So he says, there's an extra fence and a lamp. And now, you should ask him how he would like to play, how he would like the place to be rebuilt. And every person has a task for you. His task is he wants to be next to the Divine Beast Cave, so he gets a good workout to the monsters. All right. Basically, once you complete every task, you get a special item. Let's open this. We got tasty water, not really important. The main thing you want are the stat boosters, like the Fruit of Eden, which raises your health by 10, or the special item that your character enjoys eating, which raises your defense. Let's talk to this prick. And here we go. Let's use it on base lord. And get our items back. And let's continue. Let's go here. And back to the Beast Cave. And next floor. Oh great, another tutorial. I'm back. Exciting, eh? Don't give me that look. This is for your benefit. Now, here is the intermediate course. I won't repeat myself, so listen carefully. First is the lock-on. We already talked about it. L1 and R1 buttons to switch during lock-on. Next, pressing R1 activates your guard. And here are the weapon attributes and stuff that I explained. Okay, let's get on. And escape powder. Nice. Alright. There seems to be a nice little river here. Remember, rivers restore your HP to full health all the time. They don't take away your status conditions, but they do restore you. Oh, not these guys. Alright. So, remember how I said the beginning was difficult? Well, now I can explain. These stone guys take away so much of your weapon hit points. Look at that, I already lost half of them. So, until you set up the shop, you're basically screwed when you continue. But don't worry, after this floor, we should be able to set up the shop. I see. Oh boy. A little statue dog. These monsters are all stone enemies. So they take up a lot of your weapon hit points. Come on, hit me, bro. Miss. Fuck! Alright. Didn't miss there. Oh, great. Stone asshole here. Oops. Let's repair. We can't let our base lord break. Can't let base lord down. Shit, look at that. I lost like a third of that already. Oh boy. This is gonna be one difficult floor. I'm low on repair powders. Let's get some water. That's something I forgot to mention about the waterfall. It also fully charges your water. If you run out of water, you won't be able to eat any solid foods. And you will constantly lose health. Oh my god, not more of these guys. So, to the three people watching right now, are you enjoying this? Does this let you relive your nostalgia? Because don't worry, we're playing this for another 2 hours. And by we, I mean just me. Mitch! Let's see, what am I doing? I'm Mitch. Hope you remember that from the intro. Sora is the one who actually owns the Twitch account. He's having trouble, and so on and so forth. So how are you three people doing? Yeah, you wrecked skeleton fucktard. A great fat ass here. Yes, we got the drain crest. Aw, oh, and I got hit. Don't worry, he'll die. Oh, I would also like to mention, I will not be using the Broken Dagger glitch in this playthrough. For those of you who don't know what the Broken Dagger glitch is, basically, in the first store, if you press the key, if you press like X and right at the same time, and like quick it, if you do it quick enough, you can get a glitch item from this shop called, and it looks like a broken dagger. It has no name, no description or anything. And basically what the broken dagger is an attachment. And once you put it on your weapon stats go all the way to maximum. I will not be using that, because it's so easy to get, it breaks the game. It doesn't really break it if you do it like a few times, but if you continually do it, it will break your game. But I will not be getting it. It's gonna ruin the fun of this game. And I don't want that to happen. I want to play this. Well, playing this as a child, I did use the broken dagger glitch. So it was pretty damn easy, but I will not be using it this time. I will get everything legitimate. And there's our last Atla orb. Let's kill this basher. Money! And two stone guys. Not going to bother. Alright, let's get out of here. So, some things you should know. The mayor only gives you free items, but he only gives you one of each item. Oh, and this guy. Hello? Let's ask him, tell me how to rebuild your house. Don't forget to expand my room and the barbell. Alright, and how should I rebuild? Fighting, they want to go near the Divine Beast Cave. Good. Config. I don't even have the old guy's store available. Crap. Alright, we got Paige's house. We've got my house. I have a house? Let's face it this way. Whoops. And let's put down Paige's house. And let's put all the people in. Reen is my mother. Alright, good to know. We got Claude. We got Pike. Where did they go? Not there. Paige. Yeah, Pike's right there. Barbell. Let's put this back here. Put a lamp. Fence. And not this. Candy box, no. Oh. What do you know? It does go there. So, interesting game mechanic. Once you finish someone's house, you get an event when you go to the house. So, let's go in here and see what the event is. Whoa, Mitchell, you've done it! Thanks to you, our house is back to normal again. Damn, look at that fucking barbell! That's huge! I can't even lift 10 pounds! Here, this is for you. A stonebreaker. Alright. Hey, that's mine! Hey, bro! What do you think you're doing? Like I always tell you. What's yours is mine, and what's mine is mine. That's all. Okay. Interesting. Grr. Settle this like men. Oh, shit. I wonder who won. Oh yeah, other thing about this game, it has night and day cycles. Different things happen during different times of the day. Let's see. Any more of those chests? No. Let's go back in. Now that the house has expanded, there could be more stuff inside. And what's in here? Got a big dumbbell. Not a dumbbell, a little punching bag. And I guess there's nothing in here. Alright, next up. Let's go to my house. And this is... Wow, I live in a barn? What? The mom is outside, alright? And now let's see, tell me how to rebuild your house. It's your own house! Our house had a chimney and it had a storage room. Don't you remember what your own house was like? Unfortunately, I don't. Alright, that's enough talking to the NPCs. Let's talk to Mayor, get our stuff, and go on with our lives. Let's see. Let's repair. I'll probably try using the dagger more now. I always rewatch the streams that I record, and if there's one thing I've noticed, first off, my voice sounds like shit. Second, I always say alright in order to start a sentence. Oh, what's this? Basement floor. There's nothing here. Alright. Oh, please. You can't beat me. There's one. There's two. And there's three. Good fight. Aw, great. Why does a skeleton even need a jacket? You will have to duel him. We gonna play Duel Monsters?
I have a pretty awesome Exodia deck, might I add. A duel is a special form of combat.
You have to press buttons, and it's all cutscene related, alright? Shit! And... Ugh! Okay. That was brutal. Let's try again. Shit, I missed the last one. So, important thing I forgot to mention. In duels, if you win the duel and you pressed all the buttons correctly at like the best possible time, you get a free gem. And those gems really help out. Wow, look at this. I fought three skeletons and lost like 10 of my hit points. Bullshit. Next floor. Great, more tips. Pretty sure I could explain it better than you can. Charge attack. I already did the charge attack stuff. Absorbing attachment upgrades. I already did that. Already explained it. There is one thing about weapons I did not explain. So, let me just get water. I'll explain that other thing about weapons once I get to it. Shit! First, let's kill this bat. This bat's pretty annoying. Alright. Good miss. Shit! Do I have anything that can kill these guys? I don't have any bombs. Right, you're dead. Who are you? Ooh, got an endurance. Ah, come on! You bastard! Alright, this isn't going too well. This is definitely not going too well. Oh yeah, I have antidotes. Give me that bread. Yep, the beginning is definitely the hardest part. Yes! You won't be hitting me today. Oh, yes, and we got the key. And my weapon's abs are full. I guess you can put some stuff on it. Customize. You can only put two. So, let's see. Endurance, Undead Buster, Stonebreaker. Because I hate those little stone guys. Endurance. Endurance is pretty important. It stops your weapon from breaking as easily. Upgrade. Base Lord plus one. Is now Base Lord plus two. Let's put in Undead Breaker. You're garbage. Is that what that thing's called? And little leg. That's good. We know the location of everything now. Kegs. Alright. It's keg, not keg. And a map. Ooh. Okay, let's go this way. Yeah, you're not poisoning me this time. Let's open this up. Nice little bone key. Since I already got the gate key, there really is no point in killing the enemies. I mean, I'll kill the simple ones, like the bats and the bashers and the skeletons. I won't kill those stone fuckers. Yeah. Those guys just drain my hit points. And we don't want that. Oh, a fucking bomb? Awesome. Oh, I got a little surprise for you. Little bastard. Get ready. Yes! Get wrecked! Ooh, a stone breaker. That's pretty cool. Oh man, that bomb was the best moment of my life so far. Right? Oh, God. You move, like, at a snail's pace. Just wait until I unlock the shop. I'm gonna be buying so many Dran Feathers. I only have 49 Gilda. Dran Feathers are just so damn important. I'm not messing with that guy. Or you. Or you. You won't mess with me. Goodbye. Let's not go to the next floor yet. We need to get these Atla. Got a cat. I hear another cave bat. Haha. I hear a basher nearby. Well, I really have nothing to talk about right now. Oh, great, you again. Let's get this. Gaffer's buggy. Okay, Gaffer, old Gaffer, is the guy who sells the shit. He sells all of the items you'll need. Well, not really all of the items, but all the basic items you'll need. Like, you'll need antidotes, you'll need escape powders, repair powders. So, let's get up, repair his shop. And once his shop is done, we can talk to him and buy items. And that will make this playthrough so much easier. Okay, first, let's get our free shit. Hey, give me stuff. Awesome. Give me more stuff. Awesome. Ooh, fun thing. If you press R2, you can go into first person, and this only helps you in these houses, so you can really look around for the chests and stuff. Yes, I'll take that gourd. Gourds increase the amount of water you have by one. So let's give him one gourd. Wow, I'm looking at the stream right now. Loving the video quality of this. I've had some bad experiences with video quality and my sound quality. But it's looking pretty good right now. Alright, let's assemble Gaffer's buggy. Let's put you here. Oh, we forgot to put Gaffer. Here we go. Odd Gaffer. It's not old Gaffer, it's odd Gaffer. This is your item shop, alright? How should I rebuild your thing? Shop needs houses around it. He wants plenty of houses around his house. Of course, we need goods and a sign. Alright, there's supposed to be some kind of event where, like, if you don't put up the sign at the right time, then he has less items to sell. Supplies. Excellent. I think I already did that, though. There we go. Yeah, we needed to put that guy in to help with the sign. Or else Gaffer falls and breaks his back and he has less items. Yes. Now we can talk about the shop. Oh, first thing I should do, I should save. I haven't saved in a long time. Let's see, we've got all of these. Put the last file. I don't care, I'll replace it. You should see all my save files on this game. I've put so many hours in this game, look at this. These are like my master files. Alright, now that that's done, is the store open? He's got all this shit. He has bread, water, repair powders are so damn important. Speed cell. No. Damn, 500 for a level of powder though. It's pretty awesome. Oh yeah, let's sell these pricklies. We will not need pricklies. I don't want the manual either. I don't want to sell it, but I'm not sure if we should. I'll sell the stamina drink. And now... there we go. Plenty of repair powders. Probably gonna need one of these. Actually, two of these. Oh, I almost forgot. Yes, I have enough. Dran's feathers are super important. Ooh, I'll take this. Speed plus two. Pretty useless. I'll take this. Fluffy donut. Okay, let's save. I know what you're thinking, why save? The point is, these items that you get, for Tone, he eats fluffy donuts. And these items increase your defense. They give you a set of defense from 5 to 7. And it's all random, so unless you get 7, restart your game. Alright, 6. You know what? I'll take that. I will take that. There really is no such thing as maximum defense for all the characters, so 7 would probably be ideal. But whatever. Let's get on with it. Now we can finally go in and do a lot of grinding. Well, not grinding, but a lot of exploring. At least until we get to that block. I'll explain what that block is later. What now? Oh, the little cat. Cat's gone. That's what happens when you look and it's gone. Alright, first things first. Always keep one revival powder there. Always keep one Dran feather here. Or just, yeah, Dran feather should always be first. So I'll keep two revival powders. Doesn't matter. Just have a second Dran feather. Now, this is what Dran's feather does. Check this out. This is me moving. This is me moving the Dran's feather. See how super important this is? Ah, shit! Yeah, get wrecked, you fossilized shit. Alright. Come on! Yes! And these feathers, they last a really damn long time. Wow, he can hit sideways? Bullshit. No kidding. Right? And bone key. Didn't want to kill him. Yes, I love Dran's feather. So damn useful. This is the most useful item in the game. I hear something. Ah, oh, not you guys. Ah! whoops, my weapon almost broke. That's the other thing I forgot to buy. Auto repair powers. Wow, these guys. Oh shit, they can block also. I have a shitload of levels. Yeah. What you can do now? It's gonna give me a lot of money, that's what you're gonna do. Running! And this is the next floor, I don't have the key. Don't be afraid to, like, just spam your drain feather. Ooh, stendant powder. I will explain that later. Oh boy, I think this is a mimic. It's not a mimic. Escape powder. Don't really think I'll be using that. Chimney. And... yeah, one of these had to be a mimic. Yeah. Damn it. Mimics pack quite a punch. Let's use some bread. Oh, one thing I forgot to mention. Now that I set up Gaffer's buggy, the mayor will not be giving me any more free items. Let's use this. Great. If only I had more bombs. Whoops. I hope that is not on the screen. Oh good, it's not. Yeah, what do you want? You want to die? I hear something next to me. I hear something. So I haven't really been able to show off the back floor yet. Ah, fuck you. Whoops, taking some extreme damage. See, this is why the shop is so damn necessary. You need like 3 repair powders per floor. Shit! Yes! Get wrecked! Oh, thank you for that gate. Oh, I missed one of the apple. It's down there. Oh, great, a little fucking bastard. Come on. It's alright. Yeah, don't worry about the health. We can go back to that fountain and get back here. Using the power of Dren's feather. Yes, definitely the most useful item in the game. Lasts an extremely long amount of time. Pretty cheap. Only 50 gilda. Super fast. Gotta go fast, gotta go fast, gotta go fast, gotta go fast. Please don't be a mimic. Thank you. Oh, see that. Oh, my weapon apps are full. Let's upgrade this. First customize. Got Undead Slayer. Stonebreak. Let's put this on because we have a lot of these stone enemies. I need to build this up. I need more attack, endurance, I need more thunder, I need more, I think that's mage slayer. And you, I need, well, I need mod. Let's upgrade. Now it's at +3. I hear something. Excellently timed. Alright, one of these is a mimic. Is it this? Nah, I'm kidding. You cannot mimic from these. This has to be a mimic. I knew it! Well, I'm not dealing with your shit. Next floor. Me and my base lord. Ah, great, you again. I will lecture you on the back floor. I already lectured you about the back floor, like, as soon as the game began. Nothing special. Back floors, you need a back floor key that may appear in one of the chests. Oh, wow. On this weapon... Oh, are you kidding me? So, I forgot to mention this. On some floors... Skip. Get out of here. Oh, are you kidding? Okay, let me just kill this lich first. So, on some floors, there's a special limit thing on them. And those floors are limited floors. Mellow banana. Wow. Who knows what people could do with that mellow banana? So, on this limited floor, using a weapon decreases its abs when you kill a monster. Instead of gaining abs, it decreases. And you can't switch weapons. Bummer. Oh my god, what is that? What the fuck is that? I haven't played this game in years and I don't even remember this. Oh, that's nasty. Seeing as I already got the gate key, there's really no reason to continue. Killing, I mean. Yuck. So, for those who don't know, gooey state really reduces your speed by like a quarter of what it's supposed to be. Look at this! This is me running! This is me using Grand Feather! Oh! Another super box. Guess the password. Oh, shit. Well, at least it told me what it is. Successfully guessed it. And, oh, come on. That's not the weapon I was looking for. Oh, I don't need to kill these guys. I already have the keys. There's one weapon in particular that I'm looking for here, and that weapon is a bone sword. Why? That'll be important for later. Not really story-wise, but weapon-wise. Llama? What? A llama is supposed to be dead! Got a map. Shit, how long does this gooey state last? There should be a way to get rid of it. I don't have the thing to get rid of my gooey state. There's a lot of status conditions in the game. There's poison, which you've seen. There's goo, which makes you move like a quarter of your speed. There's curse, which I don't remember what curse does. There's also... let's see. Other than that, there's freeze, as in like, just stop moving. Like, they just freeze your ass. Still goo. Maybe if I get still goo. Let's see. There's curse, there's freeze, there's poison. Ooh, a treasure key. Those sell for a lot of money. Never use treasure keys, always sell them. There is a way to get rid of it. You need to use a soap bar. I don't have any of those. I'm using Drain's Feather, by the way, which is why I'm moving slightly faster. Hey, remember him? Of course you remember him. He was the guy from the beginning. And he's also Sephiroth's little brother. No, I'm kidding. Hard to believe that you are worthy of it, but that's not the issue here. Would you be so kind as to hand it over to me? No, get your own. I see. So you intend to use that stone to restore the world. A noble goal. But even if you restore the world, the destruction could repeat itself, unless you defeat the Dark Genie. Unfortunately, such a task is beyond your abilities. It is a being powerful enough to destroy the world in an instant. No weapon or man can stand and face it alone. I've come to this place, or rather, this time, for that stone. I need that stone, more than you do, actually. There is a great deal about that stone that you don't comprehend. Pardon me. I do ramble on some. Well, if you will not hand over the stone willingly, then I have no choice. Let's see what you can do, as the one supposedly entitled to the stone! Right? Well, time to fight Sephiroth's little brother. Yes, pressed all the buttons correctly. Excellent, you get a free gem for that. A acquired a diamond. You did quite well. How's this going? I could easily fry this cat. Nah, I'll get in the way of it. Whoa, is that blood? I actually have blood in this game. You amuse me, boy. You can't even handle an attack as meager as this? You cannot be worthy of that stone. It's not that you couldn't dodge, you simply didn't dodge. Deliberately. Fine then. That's it for today. I think I'm beginning to understand why the fairies chose you. It will be amusing to see how well you do. I will offer you some free information though. You cannot defeat the dark genie even with that stone. Not yet. If you have even a vague desire to defeat it, you must become stronger. Oh, I almost forgot. I have a gift for you. Have that little one return you the favor. See you soon. A changing potion. And where do you think you're going? Oh, alright. Hey cat, I'm in a lot of pain because of you. Alright. What?
So, Fairy King decided to screw with us. And did this.
Stray cat. The stray cat is part of my team. So before you guys ask, I cannot continue because of this unfortunate pool of water here with a single spike. I cannot jump this. Can't I swim it though? It's not even that far. Oh well. Let's leave the Let's leave the dungeon. Okay, now that that's done. So this part took me forever to realize as a kid that you need to put the cat here. Let's put a llama here. Does that go here? Does that go here? No. Does this go here? Here, here, no. Chimney, chimney goes here. Chimney cricket, oh. This go here, no, yeah, that goes there. What goes here? Slime, round wooden things. So barrel. Barrel goes here. And now we have an event. Ooh, let's open this. Bread! Let's also go in here. More bread, okay. And it's that little cat, meow. And the llama, blah. That's what a llama says? The llama, what noise do llamas make? Apparently it's blah. Let's get you. Beast Buster. I can't do female voices, so you'll just have to read this. A little kitty cat wandered in here. Aww. Let's give this kitty a name, alright? I'll keep all the original names except the main characters. So her name is Shell. Actually, I'll just change her mind. Her name. Let's call her Kitty. Kitty. mean, it doesn't really matter what you name her. She can't be important to the plot. Hint, hint. Alright, let's go back. Anything here? Yes, we do have some repair powder. And my clothes. Not really used to inverted. The eyes want to tell something. You swear. Let's give him. Oh, I don't know. How about this changing potion? This took me forever to figure out as a child. Because I was stupid, I didn't read the texts at all. I didn't have any common sense. Damn. You're like totally human. Yes, you are. Are you a wizard? I hate that pill and binding of Isaac. Kitty wants to help Master with the adventure. Please, can I? Please, please, please. Say yes, say yes. Wow. Is that a new friend? Oh, what's this? Oh, come on. Again? It's been a while. No, it hasn't! I have an ally. Let me give you some tips on allies. I could give you tips on allies. We don't need this. With candies, that's the most important. Oh boy, the local diabetes. Yep, probably gonna be me. And actually, no, I'm pretty thin. Really thin, I'm like 105 pounds. Oh, dusk. Let's wake him up. Or not. Okay. Huh. Well, who else can we put down the house for? Guess I need more items. Is this the pond? This is the pond. Alright, the pond is pretty cool in the game. Basically, every village has a fishing pond. And all of these things, whenever you catch a fish, you get points based on the fish and the size. And these things are your rewards that you can possibly get. And... damn, there's a lot of good shit. These gems here, they're the most important things into getting your weapon to a high level and doing high damage. Don't worry about fishing yet. It only becomes important. I guess it's actually never important. But a good time to fish is when you get to the next village. And the best time to fish is when you get to the second to last village. Actually, there really isn't a last village, so I guess the last village is really the best. You'll know which one I'm talking about when you see it. If we see it. Alright, moving on. So let me explain how allies work. Basically, you can switch allies. Allies always have something to get you through obstacles. Kitty's ability is to jump through things. Jump on those, like, one spike platforms. And her weapon is a slingshot. Aw, come on, don't go back. Kitty's ability is, or her weapon is using a slingshot. Basically, what allies do, it's just a way for the game to stall, have more depth. It really doesn't do much. Allies basically screw you over in the end, regardless. As to the next question, who should you use all the time? Should you use Tone or should you use Kit? Or your other allies? I would say always use your allies. Is never the right choice. Always use Tone. Why? He's the one with the, Tone is the one. Well, Tone can open all the apple orbs. Kitty can't touch them. Yeah, what you gonna do now? Gonna hide your head in shame? Trans feather. Awesome. Could use more of those. Map. If there's one thing we have not seen yet, those damn back floor keys. Like, I usually would have gotten one by now, but I really haven't in a long time. So here, let me show you something. This is why all of your allies are kind of useless. They can't do anything with these apple orbs. Only the main character can. So that's why I always use the main character. Unless, you know, you gotta get through those obstacles. Other than that, there really is no point. Ooh, I'll take this. And another treasure key. Oh, our Dran Feather broke. Good thing we have a lot more. Oh, come on! You bad fucker. I know how to deal with you guys. Oh. One damage. Ugh, my health is not looking too good. There is a pool down there. Oh, awesome thing. Everyone has their own health. So Kitty has low health. But Toan has even worse health right now. Kitty's health is at least full. So that's good. Ooh, let's go as Kitty. Let's get to that water fountain. Ooh, let's avoid you. Oh, come on. Fucking mimics everywhere. nice little windstone. Oh, full health. Oh, great. And an asshole to boot. Meant three abs. So next hit, the weapon breaks. Let's repair. And kick ass. Fuck! I got this. I got this. Ooh, a little minon. Okay, what is this? There's three chests here! Okay, one of these is a mimic. I know it. One of these has to be a mimic. You? Nope. Ooh, potato cake. Really important fishing bait for late game. Wow, there was only one mimic. And these three. Shit! Best thing to do is just attack them, wait for them to- alright, revival powder got used. His attack hit me and killed me. That's why revival powders are important. What stand-in powder does, this thing. So when you die, you get to use it and you change back into a different ally. Alright, so he's our super attack on him. And he dies. Taking extreme damage, whatever. Ugh. Oh, great. I don't care. There's a pond there. I can heal. So, to the three people who are still watching, I'd like to thank you for staying for this long. I mean, have either of you three played this game before? Do you remember it? Is it nostalgic? Alright. No answer. It's alright. Well, whether, even if there's only like three people watching, that three feels like 3 million to me. Ooh. Those are nice things to explore. Oh, come on, can you poison me too? Okay, let me explain what these things do. They're random pads, they can do anything, they can... But they're super helpful. They can double your money, half it, make your weapon hit points up to max, it will give you stamina. Let's see what this does. Funds decrease. Fuck you. Alright, well, just lost half of my money. Wow. Alright, there's only one enemy left. Did I already get the crest? Did not get the crest. So the game key is from this thing. See, it's usually the last person you kill. Let's go refill our health first. Oh boy, I don't know how these people who stream for like 20 hours up can handle talking this much. I've been talking for nearly 2 hours, and my throat is already starting to hurt. But I want to keep talking, even if my voice sounds like shit. Socializing, that's like rule 3 of streaming. Rule 1 was don't be an asshole, rule 2 was play what you like, rule 3 was always talk. I still don't remember what rule 4 was. Oh great, you. Wow, that did some... Let's use the repair power. Oh crap. There's little geodudes here, or whatever they're called. Oh, what are they called? Once it stops. Haha! You can't get through that chest, can you? Yeah, you can get fucked instead. Drains bones. Oh, I know how to deal with you. Awesome. I really don't think there's anything left for me to explain at this point. I mean, there are probably some things I can explain when I get to it. Wow, that poison is not going away. I thought these things go away after a while. Apparently they don't. Yes. What's over here? A great little geodude. Is there? I think I can get him. Ooh, my health is pretty low. Good thing I have all this bread. Crap! Oh yeah, yeah. Oh, little bitch. And he doesn't even drop the gate key! For a lot of money, just like those treasure keys. Another Atlo? And another chest. Yeah, it's a little asshole. No, I'm kidding, it's a gooey peach. Which, again, important fishing bait. Whoops, I picked the wrong island there. Shame on me. And we got river. Oh, I should probably heal first. Running low on bread. Damn, these guys have blocked here. It's really annoying. Yes, gatekeep. Let's see. Repair powder. Ooh, a big chest. It's locked, let's guess it. Must be an explosion. Oh, alright.
Please be the bone sword.
Damn it, it's the other sword. I need the bone sword. No, don't want me. Dealing with that shit. Awesome. switch back to troll. Switch back to kitty. And this game is just trying to make me waste more and more time as quickly as I can. Weapon. It does more damage the closer you are. So that's a good little tidbit to remember. I mean, if you guys ever played this game, this is Dark Cloud for the PS2. They did not remake this for PS3, unfortunately. There is a sequel to this game, but it doesn't really, it's not as good as Dark Cloud 1 was. Here it is. And let's go leave the dungeon. And it's night time. Let's talk to our gaffer. Alright, sell these. Sell these. Potato cakes. I don't need these right now, so I'll just sell them. I don't need these gems either. I don't need all this escape powder. What I do need... repair powder. Auto repair powders. And I think that is it. I guess one more of you. And a gold bullion. And we'll buy one of these. Basically, gold bullions are really a strange item in the game. Ooh, let's build Dran's windmill. Put the bone. Don't have a sign for that. I need a fire thing, and I need a little horn. So I don't have that. Alnette's house. Page goes to Page's house. A llama. Wow, there's a lot of llamas in this city. No. Alnette. Hag. Hag does not go here. Let's put this here. Prickly, alright. Ooh, give me this. Tasty water. And let's go in. Oh, this is a meme. Oh, they had memes back then. Gourd, awesome. Let's use that gourd. My philosophy for this. Use every item on the main character. Forget the other characters. Use every item. Ooh, fruit. Use every item on the main character. Fruit of Edens especially. They boost your health by 10. You do have a limit, but you cannot max everyone's health and water in the game. You will always be like 3 short or 1 short. How do I get to the house? There's like no way to the house. Oh, hang on, I think I know. Yep, I need the stairs, which I don't have. Oh, I could go to Claude's house. It is nighttime. Hopefully the fat bastard isn't sleeping. Oh my god! Oh, my eyes! Ugh. What? Join you? I see. Take this. Wow, a bar of soap. And cheese. Only take one piece. God. Oh. Get out of this. We will never speak of this again. Never speak of this again. Never, ever. Ugh. Let's see. Where can I put this? Okay. We bought everything we need. Let's go back. Oh, I see we have two viewers here, Super Happy Feet and Zenith. XZZeth. Shit, I can't pronounce this.
But thanks both of you for watching right now.
I know it's only you two, but you two feel like 2 million to me right now. So thanks a lot. Oh great, this is another game mechanic here. Unfortunately, this is... Remember when I said how having extra characters was useless? Yeah, I meant it. Oh, shit! Basically what the game does... Oh, I forgot to buy bread. Good thing I did not sell all my escape powers. Oh, shit. What the game does is... Some of the limited floors possible is you can only use your ally, and only one of those ally. And what sucks is that you get them, they have weak shit, you can't upgrade them easily. Alright, just buy two bread. Sell the fish bait, we don't need that. Oh boy. Alright, moving on. Yes, go in. Okay, this is my plan. We're gonna go in here. We're gonna... Just hit everything. I don't care what happens. Your only objective on these limited floors, just get the gate key. As soon as you get the gate key, leave. Get your ass back. And if the game wasn't being enough of a bitch, oh my god. Yeah, the game really is being a pretty big bitch right now. What's worse is that the game will really just give you dragons, these skeletal fucktards. Come on! Fuck this. What's this way? minions. Oh my god. Okay, these guys have low health. Look at this shit. Look at what I have to deal with. Fucking dragons. Alright, there's the revival powder. Do I have one more? Do. Crap, did that dragon fucking one hit me? Alright, get ready for the long haul. Oh my. Shit, headbutt too. Come on. I would like to apologize in advance for you guys having to deal with this. No one should have to deal with this. It's okay. See, halfway. I wish I had some bombs right now. Hell, I wish I still had that thunder jet that I just saw. Where's that, like, montage music needed? Oh my god, I thought that got me. Yeah, what you gonna do? Almost dead. Ah, let's heal up. Aim at the dragon. Come on. Alright, it's almost dead. If this does not drop the gate key, I'm going to be livid. Yes! Yes! And it did drop the gate key. Oh, fucking kill me at this point. See, magic, speed, beastbuster, wind. I don't really see a point in just upgrading these, but why not? I will give it the one magic as well. Upgrade, yes. Make my suffering even greater. Fish fuck. Okay, now that we got the gate key, let's completely avoid all of the enemies, get all the chests. Oh, holy shit. Ooh, a big chest. Please do not. It's good. Oh, and we got a bone slingshot. Fuck yeah, that's gonna be useful. Nothing. A nice little treasure key. It's gonna be a good 400 coins. Bone key. That's gonna be able to get us down there. So, super happy feet, how's it going? How does it feel to be the only one actually watching my stupidity and listening to my horrible voice? I mean, I'm pretty happy that you're here, to be honest. Oops, just get that. I never get anyone to watch these. And I never actually had someone stay watching this for this long, really. Ooh, bomb! That's gonna be useful. Give me this. The magic power. Those small attribute little cards, they're really useless. Seriously, they're useless. The only things you should ever upgrade your weapons with, like, after the first dungeon, it should only ever be gems. Gems just add so much, and they're a single item. A single item does what, like, six items do. Next floor. A bit disappointed, I did not get the weapon I wanted to. There's tone here. Aw, oh, come on. Already? Come on, Geodude. What you gonna do? What you gonna do? Oh, it's pretty fast. Damn it. Come on. Oh, I almost forgot. Always keep one repair, auto repair powder up here. What auto repair powder does is when your weapon breaks and you didn't repair it, it automatically repairs it for you. Do these have anything good? No. Customize. So let me show you what a diamond adds. It adds 5 to everything here. Which is pretty cool, but I won't use it on this. I don't need a base lord. I need to build it up. I need more attack, more endurance, more speed, more thunder, more mage bust. And here I need attack, endurance, magic, thunder, Mimic Buster and Plant Buster. I mean, let's see. Do I have an Indie? Yeah, I do have an Indie. There really is, like, you can put your stuff here to just have it on it. It gains what it gives. It just permanently gains it when you upgrade. And we have another one of these. What will you screw me on? Abs of the weapon became full. Alright, come on. Did not screw me. It was pretty generous. Let's take this out. And upgrade. Now that the weapon is plus 5, let me show you something cool. You can status break weapons. What status breaking does is you get about 60% of the weapon's power. Wow. So 60% of the weapon's power is pretty cool. Wow, that bird though. Come on. Please, I'm trying to stream. Ooh, big chest. Oh my god, no. Okay. Alright. Let's just back the pace slowly. So, King Mimics. Really rare. Really difficult to kill. I think I'll kill him a more interesting way. Ready? Get wrecked! Oh, I didn't even get any items for that? Bullshit, I didn't even get any abs for that. Those guys give a lot of abs. Thank you. Well, I think I'm gonna use this now. I think I've had fun with you, but it's time to status quo. Do I have anything? Hang on. Let's status quo. So let me show you what status breaking does. It's really cool. Once your weapon gets to plus 5, you can status break it. So your weapon gets destroyed, but you get a little sphere of it. Now let's put one of these chamfers. Put you. And once I customize, you can see. Wow, check that out.
It gains its stats. What can I build you?
I need a lot more attack, endurance, MP, a lot of everything. Fit. Ooh, looks like they hate lightning. Do I have the bone key? Do have the bone key. So that's why status breaking can be really cool. Tired of your weapon, or you don't like it, or you want a better one, just status break it and put it on the other weapon. Really, really, really upset that we never got a Trem Oil. It's very disappointing. Like, I would have expected at least one, but none at all? For my entire run-through of Divine Beast Team? It's just so sad. Oh no, there goes Dran's Feather. Good thing I have so many of you. Ooh, is this another? No, it's not a King Mimic. Explosion. Yes, please be the Bone Sword. Yes! I needed this so badly. Okay, forget this. We won't be using this. We will be using this Bone Sword. Customize. Let's put you on. Oh, my weapons have pretty good speed. Build you up to. I need a lot more attack, more MP, more endurance, more ice, more thunder, more all of that. It's okay. I will use you as well to add all of that good stuff. Okay, there's a reason I want the bone sword. You'll understand why later. Shit, that damage. Awesome. Sucks though, we never got a train. That really upsets me. Like, I had my sights on that train. And that bird continues to sing and annoy me. Yes, 2 hits. There's one thing I will say I hate about the Bone Sword. It's got really terrible weapon points. Yes, awesome. Really fun fact about those skeletons. They have a chance to be revived if you kill them. So they'll like drop back down, and then they'll get right back. Which is pretty annoying sometimes, but I haven't seen it happen yet. I think it's a low chance. Sneak attack, motherfucker! Tricycle. Switch to you. Come on, kitty. Kill this damn bat. Thank you. get the apple first. Alright, this is not looking good. Oops, wrong, sorry. Ow. Don't be a bitch. That's my job. Oops. And now you. Chests. One of them has to have the map, and this one has a carrot. Okay. Next floor. Wait. Next floor, this time for sure. So, let's keep going. I guess I'll just normally slash those guys. Since if I just combo at them, they'll block, my weapon will lose so many hit points. Not great, you guys. Yeah, that prick's looking at me. Check this out. Yeah, they see you rolling? Nah, they see you dying. Weapon almost about to break. It's okay. So, I guess there is something I could explain. Now, there's a reason why I want this sword. First of all, it's not that it builds up to, like, the best sword in the game. Another sword I have does that. The reason this sword is good, once you build it up to a certain point, it becomes this weapon known as Drain Seeker. And a Drain Seeker has an excellent ability. Every time you hit, you get... Oh my god, you've got to be kidding me. I have no repair powders? What? Oh. Please be a repair powder. Explosion. Ah, poison. What's next? Ooh, kitchen. Does it have the ability on it? It does! Okay. I guess this would be a good time to explain abilities. So, all weapons in the game could... Most of them don't have an ability. The kitchen knife has a staple ability, which is Quench. And Quench basically reduces how fast you get thirsty. Ooh. Wow, okay. This is looking good. I can't tell, am I good? No, I'm not good. I guess poison. Oh shit. Alright, I don't have any more. Oh my god, those birds, please! I love your singing, but... I would like to apologize once again for the three birds I have at the moment for making so much noise. It is about to break. It's okay, I'll use an auto repair powder. Man, I need to do some buying once I get back. Alright, so, as I was saying, weapons have abilities sometimes. The only ability almost all the weapons could have is probably durable, which makes it so they lose less weapon hit points each attack. Finally, weapon adds are full. Mimic breaker or computer. What do I need? I do not need mimic breaker. I do need endurance. Let's upgrade. Yes. And let's put you guys on just for the fun of it. Already it's on low hit points. I guess since I already have the crest, I don't really have to upgrade this stuff again. Since I have the crest, I really should just kill recklessly. Do I even have it? I do have it. Now, if I could just stop getting off track. Weapon abilities. There's a lot of weapon abilities here. There's good ones, and there's bad ones. Master Skeleton. Not dealing with you. Now, let me think. What are some of the good abilities? There's abilities like Steal, which let you steal when you hit your enemy. Others, like Big Bucks. What Big Bucks does is it gets you a lot extra money once you kill. Oh, Tramoil! This is what I was talking about. Once I finish this floor, because I have no repair powders at the moment. Wow, two Tramoils! Oh, are you kidding me? Use standing power. It's a fucking dragon. Extra money when you kill. There's also something else called abs up, which increases the amount of abs you get by 1.5. There's also, let me think,
there's drain, which is from that weapon that I got. The bone sword, when you build it up enough,
it evolves into a weapon that has drain, and it's the only weapon that has drain. Let's go to Gaffer's Buffy. Okay, what don't I need? Not need you. Not need carrots. Right, now to buy. We need 20 of repair powders. 3 of these. 1 more of these. Actually, 2 more. Feathers. I don't need these things. I'll take one. I'll take 2 of these. And I don't need water. So that should be it. Let's rebuild some houses. House.
Let's go talk to the hag, see what she has to say. Ooh, hair powder. Power powder. Awesome. Hello. Tell me how to rebuild your house. Let's see. There's a bench outside, and the jars. And how should I rebuild it? So, she'd like to be in front of Drain's mill. Dead Buster. I don't know what's in here. Right, now that she told us what needs to be in her house, let's do it. Let's see, fence, lamp, chairs, and a shop. Jar goes there. Do I have any more stairs? Where's the lamb sauce? Drain's horn. Could build this thing. I think there is one more floor left in Drain's castle. Not Drain's castle, Drain's divine beast cave. Maybe two floors. Hag's house, some clothes, and then hag. And what do you have to give me? Nice, do I get that chest? Use my closet to store items you don't need. Awesome. Which is pretty good, because you only hold about 50 items in the beginning. First, let's take this. Magic power plus 2. Okay. Let's see. Who am I forgetting? I should go to... Alnet's house? Oh, that's right, I still don't have the stairs for her house, so I can't go anywhere. Okay. Well, I got all the items. Now, there is one thing I needed to do. I want to show you guys what the back floor looks like. And I think we will find out... I want to do a high place. Alright, I'll do a high place, whatever. Let's go to floor 14. We will definitely be going to the back floor here. I am excited. I am actually almost out of time. I have about 10 minutes left. Wow, I let this drag on. Dragons hate ice. That's what Pokemon taught me.
use our repair powers. Ooh, boy, I'm so excited. We're gonna go to the back floor. Back floors are freaking awesome. While the enemies are a lot more stronger and deal a shitload of damage, the back floor chests give so much good shit. You get like power powders, gems. Let's go. Damn, dragons take a lot of weapon hit points. Hey. Ooh, my weapon almost broke. See, that's the importance of those auto repair powers. You never know when your weapon will break. You never know which last hit will do it. So why risk it and have auto repair powers? Okay, I better hurry, because I have about 10 minutes left before I have to leave to lunch. I'm not sure if I will continue the stream after lunch. I usually don't. But this time, I might make an exception. Let's use this. Oh, I don't want to go there, because it could say my weapon has become full or empty. So I guess I'll upgrade my weapon first, at least try to. Shit, I'm not getting a lot of experience. Oh well, the best place to get experience early on is probably in the next dungeon. This dungeon doesn't really have much for good experience. Please tell me there is not another dragon behind me. There it is. Ooh, poisonous apples. Didn't realize I got them. Oh, shit. Poisonous apples are a very important fishing item. You never, ever, ever sell your poisonous apples. What's this? Force it open. Must be poison. And another base lord. Sorry, base lord, but I don't need you. I have a new favorite for now. Okay. There's no way there's two big chests, right? This has to be a king mimic. These guys deal a lot of damage. Shit, look at how much abs that gave me. Pretty cool. Okay, let's go on. Okay, are you serious? Must be poison. And it's another base lord. Come on, tell me my weapon abs will be full. Come on, say my weapon abs will be full. Yes, there we go. Now let's upgrade this. What does it mean? Attack, endurance, magic, ice thunder, mage, plant, undead. I do have undead. I do have undead. So I will use magic, and I will use undead. And upgrade. let's hope you either give me some status of the equipped weapon change. Are you kidding me? What change? Let's see. Customize. I lost some fire. I lost a lot on everything. Wow, I remember having better luck with those. Alright. Now, the moment you've been waiting for. I still have 5 minutes. Check it out! Tram oil. Let's use it. Let's abuse it. Let's love it. The back floor. Ooh, and it was a nice little pond. Mine. Oh yes. Ooh, darn it. These gems, they are so fucking important. Torque is awesome. Ice gem. There's plenty of gems here, plenty of normal attribute things, and super attribute things, and another turquoise. Awesome. Yeah, I'm not dealing with you guys. But I do want to deal with this thing. Funds increase. Sweet, my money got doubled. I mean, it was only 2,000, but still, an extra 1,000 can really save you at some point. Oh, Dran Feather, bro. And that's pretty much all the stuff here on the back floor. Unfortunately, there really isn't too many chests, but when there are, they're pretty good. So let's see what turquoise does. 10 ice. 10 mimic and 10... what is this? Anti-rot. And I know garnet was good because it adds attack. 5 attack. 10 fire. 10 beast. I think that's beast, anti-beast, and anti-rock. Pretty awesome. What do I need to build it on? I need attack, endurance, I need ice, thunder. Alright, since I need ice, I will use 2 turquoise on it. So next time when I need to upgrade, it'll be ready. Okay. So I'm just about out of time at this point. It's been fun. I will at least finish the level, then go back and save. I'll consider playing this after I'm done eating lunch for another 2 or 3 hours. Tomorrow, I will probably play either continue this or play Final Fantasy X HD. So, let's leave. So, just on an ending note, thank you all for watching. I know there was like 4 people who watched at a certain point. Oh, it's going on. daytime change. But thank you for watching. Thank you especially for Super Happy Feet for putting up with my shitty voice, putting up with my bad gameplay at some points. And thank you so much for actually giving up part of the time of your day and watching this. Well, I will probably either play this in a half hour, or I will play it again tomorrow. But that's it. That's the end. Stora will be streaming at some point. I think he wanted to stream something MapleStory related. I don't remember, but he's got hardware issues at the moment. I will try my best to solve the webcam issue, hopefully this week. I will also work on fixing my shitty voice, eventually. But until then, see you next time.